Hello again, and thank you for joining us for our third video in our Protecting Workers with Occupational Health series. So far, we've covered the importance of annual flu shots and hearing protection. This week, we're focusing on respiratory health and silica. You've heard from us before about the dangers of silica dust and how OSHA's new standard, which took effect in 2016, is working to better protect exposed workers. The enforcement date for the construction industry just passed on September 23, 2017. In the US, 2 million construction workers are exposed to silica dust each year. Without proper preventative measures and techniques, exposure to silica dust contributes to the development of silicosis, a lethal condition that can cause lung cancer, respiratory failure, and other life-threatening diseases. A properly fitting and functioning respirator is a crucial piece of PPE for respiratory protection against silica dust. There are two types of fit tests that determine if a respirator fits properly, qualitative and quantitative. The qualitative method uses an individual's sense of smell or reaction to an irritant to detect a leakage in a respirator. Qualitative tests do not measure the actual amount of leakage, and the method is used primarily for half-face respirators. The quantitative method measures the actual amount of leakage of a controlled irritant into a full-face respirator or mask. Here at SCT, the qualitative test is more common, as half-face respirators are the product of choice for most construction and general industry applications. But we can do both qualitative and quantitative respirator fit tests. In fact, we can come directly to you in our state-of-the-art mobile medical unit. Paired with all respirator fit tests is a detailed medical questionnaire filled out by the individual, which is then reviewed by a medical review officer, who is a licensed physician responsible for reviewing and evaluating medical histories. An MRO has final approval over passing or failing respirator tests. To ensure proper fit of respirators, employees should be clean-shaven or have any facial hair trimmed so that it does not interfere with the seal. While beards may be fashionable, they're not safe to have while doing work with silica exposure. Workers who show up to a fit test with facial hair may be asked to leave and return with a clean-shaven face, or be handed a razor to clean up in the bathroom. Additionally, when putting on a respirator, remember to move glasses and hats first so that the straps lay flat against the face and head, ensuring a complete seal against airborne particulates. Be sure to check out our Ask the Expert video with SCT Regional Director Tom Bielema, who helped develop OSHA's new silica standard while he worked with the agency for more than 10 years. Next week, we'll wrap up protecting workers with occupational health by talking about drug-free workplace programs and how having one helps a business's overall health and bottom line. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.